Hey guys, in this video, I'm gonna go to how to prepare yourself for a run if you're an asthmatic or if you have asthma. My name is Justin Vandermark and I have asthma and I am also a runner. I've been running since I was a kid, as I previously stated in my other video with my dad. It was kind of our thing we do once you get home from work. But now that I'm being older, there are a few more precautions that I have to take now that my asthma has became severe. So let's just jump right into this video. The first thing you can do to prepare for a run is use your inhaler, your rescue inhaler, 15 minutes before running. So as y'all know, this is what an inhaler is. This is albuterol. This is what I use. I have two different sizes. This one, smaller one, and then I have a blue one, which is a little bit longer. And I keep it with me every time I go run. And that will jump right into the second tip for preparing yourself to run, and that is always have your phone on you and always have your rescue inhaler. You know, I have it in a pouch, so I keep it my inhaler, so anytime I run I always have it on me at all times, and my phone is always on my wristband when I'm running. So, and what this does is, besides having your rescue inhaler on you at all times, you can also have your phone on you in case you do have an asthma attack or something happens. You have your phone, you can call 911, get an emergency contact, and get some help. And so you never know, you can also injure yourself too. That happens. So always have your phone on you and always have your rescue inhaler. Jumping right to the third one, showing you this, it's always stay hydrated. I use this when running. I just put this in my hand right here. And while I'm running, if I get thirsty, I pop it open, chug it down, and I'm good to go. You always want to keep hydrated, you know, you never, especially if you're running in hot weather. You know, here in Buena Park, it was about 100 degrees the other day and I went for a run. Very hot, very hard to get through my whole run. And you know, of course, with the asthma, it's just even worse. Talking about running, especially in the weather, the next thing you want to do is you want to check pollen and you want to check for air pollution. You can go to the weather app in your phone, I believe. That's what I do, and it tells you how polluted the air is, tells you how bad it is, and the humidity and everything like that. So you can check. You want to make sure it's not too high of pollen in the air, and also not bad pollution, because that will affect your asthma. It'll give you asthma symptoms and could lead to an asthma attack. Talking about weather, the next tip is cold air. You want to make sure it's not too cold when you're running out there. If it is, you want to make sure you have your mouth and your nose both covered by a scarf or a bandana or something like that to keep the warm air in there while breathing. Let's jump into the next one. The next one is making sure if you are running alone, you tell somebody where you're running. You always make sure that somebody always knows if you are out of the house and you are out there running. You also want to make sure you're running in an area where there's a lot of people. Don't go in an abandoned area. Just in case something happens, you know, so if you're out there running, you have an asthma attack, you fall down, let's say I'm running and I drop my water bottle with my pouch with my inhaler and it lands on off the curb, goes in the middle of the street, I collapse there, I can't breathe, somebody could be walking by, driving by, see that, and they can go rush over to help you. So you always want to make sure you let somebody know where you're at, and it's going in a very busy area by traffic wise with people with movement like that. And then that kind of leads to the next one, is make sure you have like a medical card, not like insurance, but you have like your first name, your last name, maybe put your emergency contact on there. Also have what you have, like if you have asthma, let them know what you do to treat it with your inhaler, you know, your albuterol, whatever you use. And then also let them know so they can contact 911, they can contact your emergency contact, let's say your mom or your dad or your significant other, so they can call them, let them know you just, you know, collapsed or you had an asthma attack, and, you know, so they don't have to worry about it. So, and then you just keep the card in your pocket or somewhere on you. And then if you really have to, you can also put your PIN number for your phone in case they need to access that contact number, in case you don't, you just put your mom's name and you don't put the phone number, they can look in your phone and go to mom and then dial it, or your significant other's name, and then dial it. And last but not least, for the last tip, is make sure you plan your run, right? Plan your route when you're running. So this will help you avoid really high traffic areas with like pollution. Like I like to run in my neighborhood, but sometimes I have to run out onto Knott Street, and there's a lot of cars driving, a lot of pollution, you know, from just the floor, the trucks will just pick it up, it'll blow it in the air, and when you're running through it, you inhale that, and that could cause an asthma attack. You know, it can be an asthma trigger, give you some asthma symptoms. You know, you can get into coughing and wheezing and shortness of breath, and you know, one thing will lead to another, and there goes your run, there goes the whole thing you're trying to do by building your lung strength through running. So those are the best ways to prepare for getting into a run if you're an asthmatic. I hope this information really helped you. Please hit that like and subscribe button so I can continue sharing this asthma information with you guys. And if you have any other health condition you'd like me to go over, shoot it down in the comments. I'll read it, I'll look into it, and I'll make sure I have a well-researched content for you guys for the video. Thank you guys again for tuning in. My name is Justin Vandermark, Captain Health, and I'll see you guys on my next episode. Thanks, guys.